and then 11.
First Peter chapter number 5, 9, 10 and 11 together. I want to teach and preach God's word. I pray your ears listen and be blessed. First Peter chapter number 5 from verse 9 to verse 11. Hallelujah. Please, no noise from there. First Peter chapter number 5. Who is there? Who is there? Is anybody there? Okay, now let's read together at a count of 3. Who resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Progress by process. Progress by process. Progress by what? By process. Some years ago, a preacher preached me to the understanding that the day you give your life to Christ, everything becomes ordered. A preacher taught me and said, man of God, as you have given your life to Jesus today, there is nothing called battle that will come near you. There is nothing called challenge that you will find in life. And ladies and gentlemen, at that first stage of my walk with God, I enjoyed that opportunity. Several people will see me hold my Bible and they walk up to me and say, man of God, we heard you just gave your life to Christ. Take this money, go and buy yourself a pair of shoes. Several people walk to me and say, man of God, we heard you just gave your life to Christ. Take this money, go and use to make your life beautiful. But after a while, the tides began to turn. After a while, Christianity was not looking like a sour grape in my mouth. The same people that celebrated my salvation began to plan me coming down. And ladies and gentlemen, I started learning Christianity in the hard way. Am I communicating with somebody here? There was no longer anyone to encourage me. There was no longer somebody to tell me, pick up your Bible and study. There was no longer somebody to tell me, no matter what happens to you, it is your Christ or your Christian walk with him that matters in life. Yes, but ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to know that those who preach that there is no problem when you give your life to Christ, they were all false prophets and false preachers. Yes, the day you give your life to Jesus, your battle just started. Your challenge just started. The Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous. The moment you become a Christian, a landlord that had you as a challenge. Yes, the moment you become a Christian, to pay your rent becomes a battle. The you become a Christian, there are certain things you were doing before that you cannot have the opportunity and leverage to do. But ladies and gentlemen, I came to encourage you this morning to stand your ground. It doesn't matter what you are going through now. Stand your ground. It doesn't matter the backbiting. Stand your ground. Have you got it to a point in your Christian walk where your fellow prayer warrior is the one that is gossiping you outside? Stand your ground. Have you got it to a point where you start posting banners outside in the town to evangelize to people and your fellow pastors go there at night to set it ablaze? Stand your ground. In Ecclesiastes, the Bible says, when the spirit of a ruler rise up against you, he says, stand your ground. God is not looking for those who will stand and fall. God is looking for those who will stand and be sure. Am I communicating with somebody? We are not looking unto man. We are looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. I know for sure, when he shall come, you will stand not wanting anything. I know for sure, when Jesus shall return, you will become the church he has come to meet. I know for sure, there is a sister here. You have been tempted with all kinds of temptation, but you head on to the Bible. You head on to the word of God. You head on to your spiritual life. Am I communicating here? Even your friends backslided. They backslided because of iPhone. You said to yourself, even if you can't use iPhone, you will stand your ground. Am I communicating here? Yes, I'm talking to those men who are like the teeny Hebrew boys who said, even if God refuse to deliver us, we still will not bow. If you are in such a category that Jesus is coming to see in the nearest future, I'd like you to stand up and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Progress.
By what?
Process.
Process.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you grow in your Christian walk with God, as you progress in your Christian walk with God, God must take you through process. In the calendar of God, there is nothing like double promotion. If you miss a course, you will write the course later. It is better to suffer now and enjoy later. Scripture says, though your beginning may be small, but the later end. He said, for how many of you have seen this glory in this house, in his stomach glory? And how many of you have seen it now? He said, for the glory of the later house shall be greater than that of the former. Am I speaking to one person here?
Yes, sir.
The Bible says, if sin has enticed you, consent thou not, for there is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof is destruction. Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come where you will focus on the cross. The time has come where you will stop being distracted, because distraction is what is not your intention, but it's looking for your attention. The moment you give it attention, you become the distracted. But I pray for you today, while the crown is coming close, you shall not be distracted. I say you shall not be distracted. Paul was speaking, and Paul said, he said, even the very elect shall be deceived. But I said this to you, if others shall be deceived, you will not be deceived. I say your generation will not be deceived. Your salvation will not be stolen from you. If you scream your amen, you are the one I'm speaking about. Listen, when you truly understand progress by process, nothing will shake in your Christian walk with God. When you truly understand, you know what David said in Psalm 73 verse 3? I read that and my heart skipped. Psalm 73 and verse 3. If you read the Message Bible, David said, I was nearly deceived. Secondly, he said, I nearly missed it. Who was talking? David. Psalm 73 and verse 3. If you read King James Version, he said, my eyes almost was given to the foolish. He said, I was almost carried away by the wealth of the wicked. In other words, the prosperity of the wicked almost distracted me. Ladies and gentlemen, you know how it feels when you see somebody who does not go to church like you is having a car to drive. He has no good English to speak, but has a mansion to his name. He has nothing connected to salvation, but is doing well as it were in the face of people. There is a way it pains you as a Christian. No wonder David began to cry. He said, Lord, show me a token for good. How come the unbeliever is prospering, but me that is a Christian, I cry night and day in your church, yet there is still nothing to show? There is a way it pains when you as a sister in the hostel, you have no money to pay your hostel rent. Your porter is giving you problem. Your porter is coming to throw your things out, and there is a slave queen that is connected to Abuja, connected to a manam, and has her fees to pay. Ladies and gentlemen, when you are in that stage of life, I like you to know the Bible says, count it all joy, count it all joy, count it all joy, count it all joy. When there is an option, but you still choose to stand for Jesus, count it all joy. When there are other things to do that will make you offend God, Joseph said in Genesis 39, he said, I cannot do this great evil against God, not against the husband of the house, not against the woman, but against God. When you get to a place where you ought to commit a sin, and your knowledge of God tells you that if you do this thing, it is against the God who you cannot see. Ladies and gentlemen, then your purity has a good record tied to it. Can I say this to 37 people here? When you get to that point where you are supposed to drop your salvation, may grace pick you out of that area. May the grace of God sustain your salvation. Can you tap anybody saying, I'm being talked to? The church has over preached about about the money, over preach about favor, and has forgotten to balance it with the truth of the matter. What is the truth of the matter? That you that has nothing but has your salvation intact is more important before God than that man that has a G-wagon but has no salvation. Listen to this. Listen. When you are a Christian, you are born twice to die once. When you are an unbeliever, you are born once to die twice. Let me explain. When you are a Christian, before you became a Christian, you were born by a woman, and then you now gave your life to Christ, which is the born again. Am I correct? If you have been born first by your mother, and then you give your life to Christ again, that means you are born how many? Twice. You have been reborn twice. And that means you will only die once in the flesh, and then your soul goes to meet with God. Am I correct? But if you were not born twice, you will die how many times? Twice. How will you die? When you die in the flesh, you will still go and die in the lake of fire. So it's better to be born twice and then die once than to be born once and then die twice. And that die came to raise up militants who have been born twice. It is not a normal birth. It is called immaculate conception, where you are born without an intercourse. Am I speaking to somebody? If you are part of that gang, I'd like you to stand up and give me some noise. I'm talking about a gang of people. Listen, I'm talking about a gang of people who their notoriety is connected to salvation. Bible says, let him that boast in the name of the Lord. We are not boasting because we have shirts to wear. We are boasting because we have been beaten, yet we refuse to renounce Jesus. We are not boasting because we have a car outside. We are boasting because our salvation is still very sure. Am I communicating here? Even when the times are wrong, even when the times are bad, our salvation is still sure. Am I communicating with somebody?
Yes, sir.
Listen, a time comes in your walk with God where you can no longer backslide. I can tell you, you can no longer backslide. Because where are you backsliding to? To where? To where? When Jesus said to the disciples, will you also leave me? He said, to whom do we go? To whom do we go? You are the one that has the word. To whom do we go? You know, David did something. David backslided. David went, left the people of Israel. David who defeated Goliath. He left Israel and went to join the Philistines to fight Israel. Because Saul was against David. Saul, David needed to fight against the armies of Israel. When David put on their attire, he was dressed like them. He was living with them. Yet, the Bible says, the elders of Philistines, they spotted David. They said, is this not the man that defeated our hero, Goliath? They said, yes, he has come to join us. They said, no, we will not allow him to fight. Because this one is not part of us. He may dress like us, but he's not part of us. When he gets to that battle, the hand of God may come on him and use him to destroy us. Ladies and gentlemen, a time comes, even when you want to smoke the cigar, it can no longer light because there is a fire inside of you that is hotter than cigarette.
Yes, sir.
Coming. When you want to drink alcohol, it can no longer pass you because there is already a spirit. The Lord is that spirit. And yet the spirit of God is, there is liberty. There is no greater high than he that speaking in another tongue edifies himself. There is no alcohol that can make you high like that. When you speak in tongue, you are no longer in the places of men. You are now walking in the realms of the spirit. Am I communicating with somebody?
Yes.
Lift your hand and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There is no greater high than the high that make you speak people's language without knowing the language. The Bible says all those who came from different cities, they said to them, he said, they are speaking our languages. He says, it's early in the morning and yet you are high. You are drunk. There is no other highness than when you speak in tongues like Hannah. And even the prophet who was supposed to see vision started loose-guarding in a scene. Network was busy. Network became corrupt. And the man Eli said, have you been so drunk this morning? Bro, there is no better way to be drunk. Let your salvation be your banner. The Bible says, while the people of Assyrians were against the Israelites, the hands of Moses were lifted by Aaron and Hur. While they lifted their hands, something happened there. What happened? The Bible said, and after the battle was ended, Moses raised up an altar and called the altar Jehovah Nissi, which means the Lord who is my victory and my banner. Even when they are pushing you down, advertise God, leave your problem. If you can advertise God, lift God. Bible says, if I be lifted up, I will draw others close to me. You have to lift him. You may not have money in your pocket, but lift him. He will lift your pocket. You may not have good shoes to wear. Lift him. He will give you shoes. Because these things, seek you first the kingdom and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added. All those added value. Mama. All those added value. They will come. See, the church is raising Lilliputians as Christians. Less worded people in the crave for power and has no good foundation of the word of God. In crave for power. I was with some brethren and I said, I gave somebody the opportunity to say, read this prayer. And the person just came out. Oh, my father, give me power or I die. I said to this guy, you will not last. If your crave for power is overshadowing your love for God, you won't last. You will get the power, but the same power will kill you.
Yes, sir.
He said, give me power or I die. I said, this is why you don't die, finish. You don't die. Seek ye first the kingdom. In small little shaking now, Christian of these days are backslided. You already have the number of a native doctor. You already have the number of one malam in your phone. In case you are in church now, you lift up hands. Oh, I am sorry, Lord, you are in the rain. Let somebody just break your heart. You pick the phone. Are you Lala? Where are you? Come. Those are the kind of people who tell you God does not answer on time. God does not answer on time. His ways are not my ways. His thoughts are not my thoughts. For as the heaven is far from the earth, so are his ways from my ways. He says his light, is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. So no matter what you are saying, you will redirect me against what I'm seeing. Am I communicating here? He said, we are not moved by what we hear. We are not moved by what we see. We are only moved by the word. What? My brother, see, the era of say, somebody tell me, I just bought a car. It doesn't break my heart. It does. Buy Bentley, I don't care. Buy Jaguar, now you sabi. Build a duplex. Good to God be the glory. But bro, if you are not saved, you are not safe. Your salvation is the greatest asset you have. Your result ends here. Your salvation starts from where your result ends.
Yes, sir.
So that admission is not coming does not mean you should compromise your love for God for money. If you can give up your admission for Jesus, my brother, I tell you the truth, your salvation is better than the one who has certificate without salvation.
Yes, sir.
If there are no professors in hell, who will mind the faculty of Gehenna? Who will be the dean of the faculty of law? I want to tell you what pastors did not tell us, that when you are a Christian, your battles become maximum. Some of you, we attested to this now. When you were in the world, your life was not like this. Oh, how? Any small thing, you have options. As in the world, you have so many options, so many buttons to press, so many lies to talk about, and then money will come. But the moment you enter church, your options become streamlined to one: Jesus or Jesus.
Yes, sir.
The era where you used to sit down and the Baba tells you, oh, don't worry, I see the journey, look at it, has passed. You are not the Baba of yourself. Your salvation has become more important than every other thing. So the lecturer tells you to bow, tell him to hell with him and the result. You will die. Wow. To hell with you. Stand for something or die for nothing.
Yes, sir.
The pastor did not tell me that one day I will sleep on the well. We became too many inside the room as prayer members. We became too many inside the room. I was sleeping well outside. Those who were with me are where? I was sleeping where? Well. Not 1 month, not 2 months. I'll sleep on top well. They'll put a cloth for me. I'll sleep there because we're too many. We're close to 16 inside one room. I had to shift for them. I started sleeping on the corridor. Left corridor, went to on top well. Nobody tells you the story. All you want to see now is the glory. Let me tell you something. Anybody who has no story certificate to show you, his glory is fake.
Yes, sir.
something he or she has gone through. It is the thing you have gone through that joins faith with the word that you have read through, and that thing makes you who you become. It changes, it transforms you from glory to glory. Am I speaking to somebody here?
Yes, sir.
Anybody who has not going through certificate to show you, who has no storyline to show you, the glory is questionable. The yes, glory sir. Has a clause.
Yes, sir.
As a Christian, there are times when you cannot eat. It's part of the package. That's why he said, when I was hungry. It's part of the package. If they tell you it's not part of the package, they lied. It is there. There is a time when you'll be so broke, but your clothes is covering your brokenness.
Yes, sir.
You will still come to church and dance, but you know yourself, say, bro, food not theirs. It's part of it. When I was hungry, you gave me food. It's part of the package for members in church to laugh at you.
Yes, sir.
Mockery is part of the package for them to lie against you. False allegation. He said, but in all these things, ye are more than conqueror. Wait, the word conqueror means you have won. Am I correct? How can you win if you didn't fight? It was in the fight that you let her win that has made you a conqueror. Am I communicating? True, yes, Christ. Sir. True Christ. Meaning, when you use the eye of Christ to fight the battle, true Christ that strengthens me. He gives you strength. He gives you respite. He gives you solace. I have made up my mind. There is no going back. It's for whatever, for whatever.
Yes,
I have made up my mind. There is no going back. It's for whatever. One of my son, who is an ASP, had problem in police station. Big problem. What was the problem? His boss was angry of him that he's a Christian, does not take bribe. How can you be in my office? You don't take bribe. The guy will call me. I said, bros, be the different person in that station. He said, sir, being the different person has segregated me. It has perforated me out of the coffers of the police station. I said, don't worry. Stand out is what makes you outstanding. Standing out makes you what? Outstanding. That everybody is doing the wrong thing does not make it right. You do the right thing. You know, finally, they transferred him. He said, finally, they have finished me. They transferred him to Delta. As he got to Delta, the governor picked interest in him. He's no longer in a station with one weak khaki. He's now standing by the governor of Delta State. Let me say this to you. Where people think they are persecuting you, they will catapult you to testimony. I said they will catapult you to testimony. Scream that amen louder than your neighbor. God does not bless people overnight. No. No, don't be deceived. It doesn't. You must grow through process. There is a process you must go through. While I was preparing this message, the Lord spoke to me audibly. He said, I don't allow people go up. I allow them grow up. I don't allow them G-O, go up. I allow them G-R-O-W, grow. Listen, if I go up, I have no stem to hold me. But if I grow up, there is a stem. So that means I cannot fall down. But those who go up, they can fall. But those who grow up, they won't fall down. So those process you are going through is the process of growth. You are growing. Let me tell you, there is a point you get to in life, no matter how hunger comes. You have already gone through that process before. It's not a new thing to you. You are not a youth copper in it. Are you a youth copper?
No, sir.
Hunger don't beat you before now. You are no longer a youth copper. You are not used to it. Okay, now hunger. I beg. You will know. You know why God takes you that process? Because he knows in the future, things can be foggy. Things can be wavery. So because you have become someone who graduated from the process before, when it comes, it's not a new thing. You wither the storm. You know this one? Just imagine you that have done 7 days dry fast. Not because you were compelled to do it, because hunger compelled you to do it. And then you came out of 7 days dry. And then you now went to serve under a pastor, and the pastor is not using hunger to beat you. He's evil. He's trying to, you know, stimulate what you're already used to. You don't know me. Me, I came out of 7 days dry. How many times? And then you're using hunger to suffer me. Now, me and you will die inside this hunger.
Am I communicating here?
You, yes, because sir. You're already somebody who is strong inside. While he's taking you through that process, he's building shock observer. Because he knows in the road is straight and narrow. It's full of gutters. It's full of potholes. But then it makes you strong. So that when you get there, the mountains that seems insurmountable, you surmount it. Caleb said, give me that mountain. I will scale it. Why? Because this one was a man that Moses held his hand and said, follow me to the mountain. Which mountain are you now bringing? The one that his mentor took him through? Which other one? Be strong. Be vigilant. Be stronger. Be vigilant. Become a strong Christian, not a Lilliputian. Not a Lilliputian. Let me tell you something. If a prophet gives you a prophecy that is not in line with your destiny, say no. But no, anyone that you come, oh yeah, and receive. Whether it's even in line with your destiny, you are not, you don't know. You don't know. Because you don't know who you are, everything that comes, you accept. Somebody calls you and say, I saw a dream that you died. You, so God allow you pass through Bible school to one kill you. You want to one preach in heaven? To who? God allow you go through training and yet you don't want to reign. I pray for you from today. Bible says, if thy eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. From today, the light of God shine inside of you. I said, the light of God shine inside of you. Say that again, amen, louder than your neighbor. Am I speaking to somebody? Sit down. Sit down. In Hebrews 5 and verse 8. In the time he was the son, he lacked obedience through the things he suffered. Though he was the son, Jesus, yet he lacked obedience through the things he suffered. Hebrews 5 and verse 8. My brother, suffering is part of Christianity. The Bible calls it long suffering or suffer long. You don't understand me. Suffering is part of the package. Lack, want is part of it. The day you were coming to come in and say, dear Lord Jesus, I come to you as I am. My brother, for some people that was like a mistake. Because the moment you did that thing, Satan said, God's elect is Satan's target. When I say God's elect is Satan's target, the day you become God's project, get ready for APC and PDP government to spoil your life. When God makes you a project, evil will rise up in its full force. From Olango, the day you become Samson, get ready for Delilah. Prepared from hell to waste your life. But the Bible says, in all these things, yea, and more than conqueror. It says the other day, I and they, Joshua said, I and they, the Lord has given me, we are met. As for me and my house, Isaiah said so. As for me and my house, we receive the Lord. Joshua said so. Isaiah said, I and they, that the Lord has given me, we are made for signs and wonders. You know, even some pastors now, they are Lilliputians. No word base. Any small shaking, they carry their shaking online. Oh yeah, they will not put small things for you to know that they are dead. There's a way to write it. Oh, my son I raised has broken my heart. Which heart? Which heart? You know where? You know where? Nobody should break your heart.
Now, so
anybody who breaks your heart is because you gave your heart to them. When God trained you, he trains you to guard your heart. Guard your heart against any form. He will always tell them, hold your peace. Hold your peace. Who do you expect to rise against you? Those who you didn't help. It's those you help that will rise against you. They will break your protocols. They will mess you up. Fine. Count it all joy. Because anybody who breaks your heart is karma. His own heartbreakers are warming up.
Oh.
Leave karma. Karma. Just leave it. As they all do their own. Okay. You pray for themselves. It is well with you. You're all different. And when it comes, it's an updated version of Android. Upgrade. If you broke her, they will broke your neck, broke your leg. POP, POP, you be, that's how you be jumping. Your Christian work of God should teach you that no matter what happens, God is not a man. Those who told us that everything is fine, they lied to me. One of the guys I met in Nifes, a great man of God, he told me, this work that you are putting your hands on, are you sure you are ready? I told him, I'm ready. I'm ready. So a few months later, I was looking for his number to call. My brother, can you change that? He's like, I'm not ready again. Because the very people I thought would lift me up, they were the ones that brought me down. David said, if not, if it was a stranger, I don't have a problem, but a familiar friend. Somebody we ate together. Somebody we saw together. Like I said before, if it doesn't come from process, then it's not of God. Watch this. In Daniel chapter 1 and verse 7, that was where the Daniel was selected. Am I correct? In Daniel chapter 1 verse 7, Daniel was selected as who? As one of the people to be given food to eat. He was selected as one of the princes that are more knowledgeable in Israel. But before he was selected, the Bible never went detail to tell us what this man went through. This man was chained hands and leg. He trekked from Israel, Jerusalem, to Babylon. Bible never told us that one. The process was not said. It is the arrival that we heard. Before every arrival, there is a process. There is something Daniel went through before he became one who discovered my book. Before he became one who reigned, there was something he went through. You must understand that as a person going to a destination, there must be a process. There is something. There is something. Top your neighbor, say there is something you must go through. Say neighbor, there is something you must go through.
There is something you must go through.
Verse Samuel 16 and verse 13. The Bible says, and David was anointed king in the midst of his brethren. But before his anointing, are you aware David was a fool and he hates men? David was in the bush. His address was in the bush. He began to eat with animals. He began to sleep with animals. He began to fight for animals. He was there for years. The Bible never told us deeply about those ones. They only told us that he has been anointed king in the midst of his brethren. So ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to know that the process is more important than the arrival. Oh, there is always a process. Even as a ministry, there must be a process. My brother, this did not just be like this. I'll tell you where we're coming from. This first amp we used was 4,000 naira. You know, amplifier. 4,000. It's not the normal, it's not a power amp. It's not a mixer amp. But they wrote amp on it. It's not power amp. It's not mixer amp. They just wrote amp. Now, as we are preaching, if you move away from the amp, not even from the mic, from the amp itself, you'll not hear anything again. So you have to be around the amp. Praise the Lord! The children will be begin, Lord, 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 Lord. You be going. You wait for the Lolo, Lolo to end. If you're not say, the Lord, 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 Lord. Lord. Anis, 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 Anis. There's always a process. Finally, one guy told us he wants to sell his speaker. He wants to leave town. He's a church. I say, hey, which kind of guy? He said, foreign. Foreign. Or bad way. My brother, we went there, we bought speaker. We didn't know it's speak on. It's speak on, we bought, not speaker. When you are talking, you'll be hearing, you will not hear your voice. Only all you'll be hearing is, you see, I can preach in any sound. Even let it just be a one sound. I will preach there because I know where I'm coming from. I'm coming from 4-battery tape. 4-battery. So anywhere you put me, I'll go shine. Bro, I'm nervous. We didn't have band. We have jazz. Jazz is not jazz band, though. Jazz. Other than chaku, chaku, chaku. When you are playing it, chaku, chaku. You'll be dancing with it, chaku, chaku, chaku. Instead of psh, you'll be adding pa, pa. It's not simba. It's signboard. That is the signboard. Ayo, samba. Yeah, pa, pa, psh, pa, pa, psh.
and every all-night drum must burst. Because the only sound he can play is chaku, 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 dudu, chaku, dudu. Person when don't cross the banana, not the fear erosion. You're coming from process, you are coming from somewhere. Don't just jump and become somebody. No, first be nobody before you become somebody. That's when you can be traced to somewhere. No, all the way from nowhere. Joa. Your name is Francis. You are from this village. My brother, la la, I talk. There's always a process. Don't just start like that. Process, process. And after process, there is timing. And after timing, there is the set time. For even the gift to manifest. Or for even the gift to be advertised. Process. Lest you become proud. He makes you go through process. He told Paul, I would have taken this thing away for you, but I left it for you so that you know that you are not God. My grace is sufficient there in your weakness. Hi, I wish I was talking to one person here now.
Yes, sir.
I wish I was encouraging one member that was almost giving up, but is not saying, I didn't give up. I've come too far. Esther, in Esther 2:17, and the king has accepted her. The king brought her. Who was Esther? The very person that was washing plates, clothes for his cousin, for her cousin, sorry. He was washing things, taking care of her cousin's house. Who was her cousin? Mordecai, the gate man. And the Bible says Mordecai kept on going to the king's palace to know if Esther had failed or he has passed. Process. A servant to the house became a queen as Vashti was taken away. Am I speaking to somebody? Joseph in Genesis 41, verse 41. Pharaoh handed over the kingdom to him. Genesis 41, 41. Pharaoh handed over the kingdom to him. The Bible after then did not tell us how the guy was sold. The person who was giving the kingdom now, he was first sold, he was thrown into prison, he was accused wrongly. Those were the processes. And the price he paid for him to become ruler in the stead of Pharaoh. There must be something you go through, my brother. Don't be deceived, though. There must be something. No matter the prayer you pray, going through has no respect for your prayer. Pray against it. If it is God's will, you will go through it. Pray against it. There will be time when there will no school fees. Exam, they will write it. You won't write. And God is just in heaven. Okay, let me see if you will deny me. Bible says, what can separate me from the love of God? And he began to mention things. What can separate me? If your school fees is not paid and you miss exam, will you still call God God? My brother, if your school fees is not paid and at the end of it all, you miss the exam, will you still call God God? Will you still be bold enough to stand? It's like you sang today, right? Nice song you sang. Wonderful. I listened to you. You were singing just now. If your school fees have not been paid and you miss your exam, and that's automatic carryover to extension, will you still serve God? My brother, it never happened to you. It never happened to you. It don't happen. I'm not sure. Professional exam, where you have to drop out of school, you, that your conscience will die, depression will be a learner.
Yes, sir.
Depression will be telling you, sorry, you have passed me. Depression will be telling you, sorry, you are greater than I am. When you are going through all of this and you are still able to stand on the altar and say, Father, Father, we declare that we love you. We declare our everlasting love for you. Are you sure? When your landlord, you know, when you just carry, come, sir, you just carry your new fiancé to the house and you now put camphor anywhere. You know how you know a broke boy? It's the day you enter the house, everywhere is full of camphor. It's too broke. There was nothing there before. He just, because he knew you were coming, he now put there. It's not even camphor. Is it sunshine? They call it all those things.
Yes, sir.
Sunshine.
Yes, sir.
That thing that smells more than smell.
Yes, sir.
I don't know why people use that. Sunshine. Okay. He now put the sunshine everywhere. When you now enter the place, you now start smelling camphor and sunshine. He just want to pack it. He will dress the bed, dress everywhere. Those era where they used to put chair, they would not put something like cotton on the chair. You know that thing, no?
Yes, sir.
As they sit down like this, the thing will be here.
Yes, sir.
Something like cotton. You now rest on it. The girl will now ask you, is this your house? Yes. 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 And as he's just doing that, yes, 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 sir, landlord just shoo. Idiot! Whoa! It is, I don't catch you. Since morning, now you run. I don't catch you. How your body go do you? You look the girl. You look the landlord.
He does.
You will on yourself. You want ground open now. Don't, let me your die.
Show don't spoil.
And then in the midst of all those die, the people who are in the world, who first told you to come and join them, they will not come and tell you, shall I tell you, you don't get level. How many of you will still by that time say, Jesus, all this is I'm going through, I will not still fall. How many? Only few persons. Only few persons. My brother, it is in going through all these things that your faith is known. Am I speaking? I tell people, bless you, sir. I tell people, the place where you have the best Christians are in the north. Not here. If people here knock out outside here, my brother, you see this window that is locked? It will be open. be open. Be open. You see all these women are your tired upon one level. Let them your ear. Bosa, bosa. Or not even the real gun. You know those Indian film gun? Real pa. Indian film, they will shoot the gun. Be like, kosa, kosa, kosa. It's like music. This place now. You see this place? They will overtake this place. Overtake this place. I know them. They will take here. You see that place? Those ones will be in Iran. Before the jet off, sir. Just here, trailer. Those there, trailer they used to bring them from the north, just park. You, one person, if I observe. that observe like this now. Etwaje, hear me. Oh, your things were moving. Before they just jumped up and go, you said, phew. Like the day armed robbers blocked us on the highway. I was the big joker, my brother. All those large women, they were passing through windows. I said I should look back. Behold, the tomb was empty. Very empty tomb. See movement. Women inside Gary Farm. All those kind of race where their back leg begin to touch front leg. Take off. Movement. Only small. Who is that? You're already shouting, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You know, my father told us a story of a drama troupe that was going to add drama in the church. And they were dressed with demons, dressed like all those kind of people. And they were going and it began to rain. Because of their costume, they had to hide in one church that was in the street. So the rain will finish before they continue their journey to the church. They want to go and act. As they were there, the pastor was about praying against the devil. He said, ladies and gentlemen, as I'm talking to you now, the devil is inside church. if you see men moving, men, all those metrics that you are watching on film, is real. Squire, instrumental, squire. It was only one elderly woman that was left. So the devil was coming. Met the woman and said, but that why you not going? He said, my son. When the woman begin to call devil, my son. He said, when they were binding you just now, I'm not talking anything. You see my mouth. You didn't see everything. You check my mouth. Now, let's even take for instance. Say, as we are finished prayer just now, you know we pray against witches and wizards just now, marine. As you just go now. Well, let's close all night now, you are going now. You just really come. Jay, Queen of the Coast. Between God and you, my brother, tell truth. You know, there's a reason why God make us the pray. May we not see some things. You go really pray, you just see the thing on. Oh yeah. You, say my brother, no, I'm with you. You know the early prayer where I'm binding us for you. I'm binding us for you. No. Stand your ground. I told them, I said, it is in the north. I've been there to preach many places there. Sokoto, Fafa, North, Kano, Kaduna, Jos, Gombe, Nasarawa. I've gone to all those places to preach. But listen, that's where we have Christians. With all the boom, 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 everywhere, they are still what? They are still consistent. In church, there was a church in Abuja, a Catholic church that was blown up. People died, children died. People scattered everywhere. You heard about it some years ago. The next Sunday, people still went there for church. Let there be knockouts in Benin. That's why our pastor will. That's why they have a WhatsApp group. They will share it. Brethren, wisdom is profitable to direct. Let's do services in our individual house. I will talk to you. Fear not, my brother. When you stand like this, and they put a machete on your neck, and you are still saying, Father, unto your hands I commit my spirit. You are still letting them know that you can only kill my flesh, but you cannot kill William Branham before he died. He preached a message and said, you can only kill this body. But several thousands of years, even when I'm dead and gone, my voice will still be speaking. Till today, people still watch William Branham. He's dead and gone. He said, even if I'm true, my voice will still be speaking. And his voice is still talking. My brother, get to that point where death has no meaning to you. Death only becomes a change of address. Because whether you like it or not, there is nobody that will not die. Nobody. The best thing now is to be aware that no matter what happens, that is not your full stop. It's only a change of address. It's only an access to another level. The only thing you should miss in death is that the person who dies, you will never see him or her again. That's the only thing you should miss. You won't see him again. You won't see her again. It's obvious there's a vacuum. But the truth of the matter is that death is a price that even the living, every living soul will pay that price. Every living soul. Our prayer is for us to go long or go old before we go. But everybody will go. Everybody. We are the generation where 60 years old is celebrated. We don't call it celebration of life. Because this life is not even too short. Isn't it like yesterday when we were driving tire on the street? Oh yeah. How many of you drove tire? Where are my brethren? Brethren. How many of you catapult bed? Aha people. I know who it be. How many of you will? Willy. See ladies raising hands. I'm not doing anything. Where are they? You did it, sir. Will. Oh, you know, is it crown's pocket they call that thing? Or crown? That's in the whole chain. What do they call it? Crank. The whole chain from the back. You now put two wood. Shh. You can't eat all joy when you drive wheel. There's one they used to use spoke to do. You bend the spoke. And then you now put a... Oh, my mom's cover of paint. They will always miss. I will collect my friend's room. She will just start shouting, hey, hey, hey. That's how I'll carry the stuff. Stress. That's why you are sweating profusely. But yet you are not disturbed. You keep moving, keep pressing. You keep pressing. I love that life. Life of felele, no head. Who play head? Felele. As you kick and hear, toyoin. Don't be moved by their glory. Be moved by their story. Let somebody tell you what he has gone through, not where he has gotten to. Where he has gotten to, everybody can get there. But what he has gone through, not everybody went through it. Learn from there. And two things we got to do before we begin to pray. Number one, every man that must have a story to tell must learn focus. Somebody say focus. Shout it again, say focus. James 1 and verse 8. He said, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Be focused. Don't be distracted by friends. Don't be distracted by those who call themselves your friends. No, sir. If they are not going where you are going, they are not your friend. Show me your friend and I will tell you who you are now and who you will become later. Focus. Revelation chapter 3 and verse 16. He says, so then, because thou art lukewarm, you are neither hot nor cold, I will spill you out of my mouth. Don't be double-minded, be focused. He said, because you are lukewarm and you are neither hot nor cold, be one person. Don't be double-faced. Be who you are. Psalm 25 verse 15, I love what David said. He said, my eyes are always toward the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net. My eyes are always toward the Lord. Brother, anybody who has too many opinions or too many options should be avoided, because that person is a major disaster. He must be focused on one thing. Write down the vision. Make it plain. You are dating somebody. He tell you today, what do you want to do for a living? I want to travel abroad. Is abroad a job? People are coming back. You say you want to travel. Ask what? I want to travel abroad. My family, my mommy now say they will sell land. I did not finish telling land. Then they will not give me half to not go. And the land they want to sell is after we leave or go double. Who will buy? Before buyer will reach there, your beards become white. There are people who are still sustained by that one now. I want to travel abroad. My brother, there are people that want to come back. I have seen people abroad who tell me, man of God, if I have the opportunity, I will come back home. There is no place like home. It's not foundation. What is there is too heavy. You will pay for dustbin. In Nigeria, dustbin yaga yaga everywhere. Sir, you've been abroad for years. Don't you pay for dustbin? You pay for light. There is no illegal connection. You don't even know where wire is. If they floor it under the ground, you don't see wire. You don't see it. Talk more, say you now go and connect your light. You know some of us who are still in the bamboo ministry. First line get, you are not in Nepal, but you have lost the job. First line get, no. Oh yeah. In the night, you have become an expert. You don't carry hand. You don't show. Light will not kill you in Jesus' name. When I was in my mom's house, I did an underground connection. Nepa was knocking on my door. Bros, we know so you get light. They say, I'm telling you what Nepa people told me. They say, bros, you get light. I say, yes. Bros, where you for connect? They could not detect where I connected. They went to bring police to come arrest me. Police. We don't know where for get light, but to get light. You see, you have not discovered anything. That's why nobody's after you. Discover something. We take the wire, pass inside pole. You know pole, where time I chop, where I pass them. They saw the light, but they didn't know the source. Hire me. Hire me. They brought police, boss. They didn't come with this. They brought boss of police, boss. For only moi. When they came to carry me, they put me in the back. I put my hand in my pocket. Oh yeah, what Joshua? Illegal connection. God will help us. There are people that want to come home because they are not used to that life. Me and my apostle, we were crossing in Dubai. And so black African, they say, hey, my brother, no. Stop for them. Let the light green. I said, which light? You know, in traffic, there is the red light, there is green light, there is amber, which is yellow, right? They also have that for human being. Yes. The traffic light will show green. Human beings will cross. I go cross, my brother. Now, they tell me, say, well, you will pay 450 dirham for crossing. They say, yes, camera will pick you. They will trace you to the hotel where you are. I come and give you a ticket. You must pay. We are not used to that one.
They taught us in school. They didn't even tell us to do traffic light. They say, look left, look right, look left again, across. Nobody taught us about traffic light. Even the auntie went teach us all of the day. So if police arrest me, I'll be calling their name. Miss Okose, appear. All of you will come outside. When you were school, they teach you how to cross through traffic.
No, no sir.
They only said, look here. Look here, and then make sure you look here again.
Yes, sir.
Because one useless man may come up from this side. That's to show how very civilized Nigerians are. In Lagos, there's what they call Kai. The one is just for crossing. If you cross where there's a pedestrian, you cross under, they will hold you and you will pay. I don't know how true it is. One guy crossed and the Kai ran and followed him. Go to the other side of the road. Hold, you cross. He say he hold himself. Even you cross, you don't wear our capas. Let's arrest ourselves. You want to correct me with an error? Is there a right way to do a wrong thing? No. You cross, I cross. Pay 25k, give me. I pay the 25k, give you back. So our brothers are not used to those life. They want to come home. It's just that their mother borrowed meeting money to send them there. They don't know how to come, tell their mother, say, will they come us? Or else their mother will come to church. The pastor, you know what I said in my dialect? I said, they would now say, pastor, the head of my son is no longer correct. How can he get to abroad? He say he wants to come back home. You don't know what they are going through. You don't know what they are going through. Some people are in New Zealand with cold in the highest degree. In Canada, in Russia, the cold in Russia is terrible. But when they remember meeting money, bank, what they call those money they used to carry? Groom me, Lapo. Say, hey, when you Kobe. Let me remain here. Least I go and feed my family. But I pray for you, you will not fear. So be focused. Second thing, learn from their end. Jeremiah 17 and verse 11. Learn from their end. He said, as partridge seated on eggs and hatcheth it not, so is he that getteth wealth, but not by right. He will lose it in the midst of his days. And the Bible says, at the end, he shall be a fool. Ladies and gentlemen, when anybody gets wealth that is not genuine, he will lose it. Do you know in the old days, there used to be people they call 419? You know 419? They will play people a game and all of that in the old days. Am I correct? Where are those men today? Where are their properties? Where are their children? Anytime you get wealth that is not by right, you may lose it.
Yes, sir.
And the Bible says you will lose in the midst of your days, and at the end you will become what? Onyuki.
Yes, sir.
At the end you'll be a fool. So never be enticed by anybody's glory. I've told you this story several times. We were building church there at the other side. We are about roofing. The roof has got to somewhere else. A man came with jeep after I prayed all night that God should send us help. A man came with jeep. The jeep was heavy. So I said, God has answered my prayer. Oh yeah, sit down. He said, I saw man of God that you put a beauty. Wow, this is a nice one. And the man told me something. He said, what do you need now? I mentioned what we need. At the end of it all, he said, okay, I should pray for him first. I wanted to pray, and then I began to hear the cry of a baby. I said, sir, are you hearing what I'm hearing? He said, what are you hearing? I said, baby, I cried. Babies. He said, man of God, that's why I came. I said, why? He said, I went to Ghana and they took me to a woman to get money. He says, I got there. A 2 weeks old baby that is still alive was put inside mortar for me to pound. And he took the pistol and he pound the baby life to death. As he killed the baby, he became very rich. Had houses everywhere. Had cars everywhere. But anytime he's going around, you'll be hearing the cry of that baby. Let me tell you, of what use is wealth when the wealth came and didn't give you peace? Of what use is wealth when the wealth came and your mom is not there or your dad is not there to enjoy it? Of what good is wealth when your brothers who should glamour in your prosperity are nowhere to be found? Ladies and gentlemen, if it has not come, wait, it will come. And when it comes, you will know that it was God. The Bible said the blessings of God maketh rich and added no sorrow. Don't be disturbed when a ritual has become wealthy, because he has just a little lifespan. After a while, who used to hear of Victor of Kafa? He used to be called the wealthiest man in the East. He was a very rich man. They used to call him Ezego. Ezego. Ezego was his name. I stumbled on his brother in Kano. I was prophesying and I said, Who is Okafor? The man came out and I said, there is the spirit of dead people after your life. He said, yes, sir. I said, what happened? He said, my elder brother was Victor Okafor the day Ezeko. There is no new card that come out that Ezeko does not have. How many of you heard of Ezeko? He's from Iyala. Iyala. Anambra State. Why you are going to Imo? Iyala. That's where he is. His house till today, nobody's inside. Because when people enter, they start hearing children's noise. Of what good is the blood money when you are not living long to eat it? Rise up on your feet.
Oh.
If it has not come, wait, it will come. And when it comes, it gives you peace. The blessings of God make it rich and added no sorrow. If it is, he said, every good and perfect gift comes from God. My brother, don't be enticed. If it never come, wait, it will come. You didn't hear what I just said. If it has not come, wait, it will come. It will come. Pastor, if the place has not packed, wait, it will get packed one day. Just keep doing what you are doing. Keep connecting. One day, it will come. It will come. The money will come. The fame will come. The favor will come. The breakthrough will come. The connection that you are talking about, it will come. Contact will come. Bible says time and chance happen next to them all. It may be their time now, but your turn is coming. I said your turn is coming. I said your turn is coming.
Hey,
I said your turn is coming.
Hey,
was it not like yesterday here when things were bad? We could not feed, we could not eat. It was like yesterday. Yesterday here, it was like yesterday here. I still sit down and look at it. It was like yesterday here. When I went to preach for a man, and the man told me, why did I come with this suit? That he cannot allow me preach. He said, why did I come with this suit? The church, only God knows what's happened now. Let me tell you, it's not the container, it's the content. There is something inside. He said, why did I come with this shoe? Oh. Why did I come with this suit? Okrika, say, at your age, Okrika. It is well.
When peace like a river attended my way, when sorrows like streams beat us forever, thou taught me to say,
that is the testimony Jesus wants to hear. That is well with your soul. How many of you know Kanye West? You know Kanye West? You are West now a Christian. He's one of the most popular evangelists in the US now. He's a dogged supporter of Trump. He's casting everywhere. He's going to cities to preach. He was one of the richest musicians at a point. Lost everything. Became bankrupt. And he came out and said, if it is not God that gave you, then it's wasted. If it is not God that gave you, then it's not of God. How many of you know Rihanna? He was in the choir. Till he one day stood up. He said, since she sold her soul to the devil, she has become one of the most popular women. She has sold her soul. You know what the Bible says? He said, give bow to me, and I will give you anything your eyes can see. Satan can give people money, but he will take your soul. What shall it profit a man if he gain the whole world and forfeit his soul? Pastor, why running after material things? Let me tell you, when you are not matured for something and you go ahead of God to get it, you are not secured for that thing. God grows you, secure you for any good thing he wants to give you. He won't give you cap that will take your head. Do you know that there are things that the devil will put in your hand? It looks like free gift. You put in your hand so that you can become popular for kidnappers to kidnap. Yes. There are things, because you are not matured for it yet. You are not matured. There are things you are not matured for. I prayed some prayers some years ago. Lord, anything that I'm not matured for, don't give me. Because when it matures you, it gives you capacity to control it. Least that thing controls you. I'm not in a hurry. I said this all the time. I'm not in a hurry. I'm just
following. You know how many things I hear? People call me, don't say I should tell you this will happen. I say, tell the God that I've not heard him. I have to hear him. I've not heard him. So as I'm far, I've not heard him. It's not in dictionary. It's not time for anything. There's nothing. In fact, I don't have anything in my mind. If it is time, he will speak. And when he speaks, it will be peace. He will speak peace.
Audio Jungle.